deep in the ESPN tape library, the worldwide leader in classic sports launched a series designed to take a new look at old games. They called it Cheap Seats with Ron Parker. Parker, an anchor with attitude, was helped thanklessly by tape librarians Randy and Jason. The show was slated to go all the way. But moments into the first show, tragedy struck. With Ron on the DL, somebody needed to step up, like Gehrig for Pip or Brady for Bledsoe. Sitting 2 and 3 on the hosting depth chart, that someone was Randy and Jason. That is their story. And this is Cheap Seats without Ron Parker.
Hello and welcome to Cheap Seats, the show that takes a new look at the old games and other sports-related stuff. Today we'll be taking a look at two different events, the 1990 International Kennel Club of Chicago Dog Show and the 1990 Collegiate Cheerleading and Dance Team Championships. Now, we paired these two shows together for a reason. You see, the cheerleader and the dog are two of the most loyal creatures known to man. You could be the 16th seed in the NCAA tourney, losing by 30 points in the first round to Duke, and it's still, go Murray State, you're number one. Or you could be fired from your job, dumped by your girlfriend, and your dog will still lick peanut butter off of you. Plus, neither of them mind if you throw them up in the air or forget to feed them. All right, let's get started. Bring on the dogs. Cheerleading.
No. Dogs. Dog show.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Dog show.
Yeah.
There are over 50 million dogs.
That looks like New Jersey. Jade, that is such an easy joke to say that an ugly-looking building looks like New Jersey. That could be anywhere.
When you've made up your mind your dog is more than a family pet, this is the best avenue for showing it. Hi, everyone. I'm Pat Scanlon. We're here in Elizabeth, New Jersey at one of the many...
Take a look at how much Pat Scanlon's blinking. Totally. Maybe he's allergic to dogs.
I really can't do the gig. I'm allergic to dogs.
Shut up, Scanlon!
But my throat will close up.
Just shut up and get out there and put on a yellow handkerchief!
Like the International Kennel Club of Chicago Dog Show. But others, like the local scene, just fine.
We go to, from the local shows right on up to this coming season, we'll be in Madison Square Garden.
Not for a dog show. We got Liberty tickets. We got next, yo.
It's much better to start them at the local level. So
is that dog hanging from the ceiling?
Yeah,
that's a dog from De La Guarda.
And once they get used to it, then...
Get your hands off my neck, woman.
We're from Raritan, New Jersey, and we just hear a lot about
twins hanging out and doing the same thing together. That's lame.
We want to learn to junior showmanship so that we become...
What's that dog doing behind him? And why are their mouths wired shut?
They're easy to get to.
Mike Singletary.
More convenient for me. And it enables
me
to
sitting on my dog.
Weekend, as long as it's not over 300 miles.
What happens at the 300-mile mark? His electronic ankle bracelet goes off.
...of local shows, but right now, let's go to my colleague on this telecast, Ann Rogers Clark, who's standing by in Chicago.
Now, before we take you out to Chicago, the FCC has required us to read this statement. What you're about to see may shock you. It may terrify you, and it's not suitable viewing for children under the age of 13. Parental discretion is advised.
That's right, Pat, and here we are in Chicago.
At the that is one big, ugly
dog show.
Banner.
2,700 dogs are gathered.
Here's the funny thing. She's not even wearing shoulder pads.
They come from all over the
country. Wait a second. Are we sure that that's not Pat Scanlon, too? Split screen it. That cross-dressing b***h! He totally pulled a tootsie to get to the bigger dog show. But you know he's gonna be in trouble when he falls in love with this woman. Now, what was the point of that whole Elizabeth, New Jersey intro if the event is taking place in Chicago?
Yeah, it's like doing a special on the Cape Cod League and how it's so much better than Major League Baseball right before you show a Cubs-Cardinals game. It makes no sense.
I know.
And what would a dog show be without lines? And
I don't know, that, almost tolerable?
Chicago's Deep Dish Pizza. It's a chance to get your picture taken with Dreyfus from Empty Nest.
Dreyfus, the dog from Empty Nest?
Maybe, if we're lucky, they'll have Vicky, the robot from Small Wonder, walk him around.
Here's some of Dreyfus's best work on the show.
Hey, Dreyfus! I'm going to be...
God, soap really has gone downhill. At least the kitchen looks real.
Dreyfus, there's a burglar breaking into the house, threatening your loved ones.
Hilarious.
Oh, Oh, now he's going to steal your food.
Hey, Ram, wasn't that dog hilarious how he wouldn't do anything when the guy was talking to him? Ram, do you want to watch more of the dog show? Will that make you happy? Do you want to watch some more clips from Empty Nest? And scene. No, you can kill the laugh track. No, we don't need it anymore. CJ, laugh track, always funny. I guess. All right, we'll be back with more cheap seats. Right after this. The 1990 International Kennel Club of Chicago Dog Show attracted over 30,000 people, more than five times the crowd that attended the Cubs game 2 days earlier.
Yeah, but that was a spring training game.
Still, that's 29,950 more than I thought would be at a dog show.
Really? You thought that many people would be at a dog show?
Nah, I rounded up.
Okay, well, let's head back out to Chicago for the start of the show.
And here's a unique aspect of the Chicago show, junior judging.
It's where nerds learn to be nerdier.
Number of years.
Oh, yes, they're judging those kids? That's awful. Yeah, it's hard enough to go through puberty. Now you have to be judged? All right, if we have to. Okay, this one needs a new haircut.
This one's on the fast track to a Russian mail order bride.
And this one could stand to lose a few.
And I understand you had a chance
okay,
to judge.
Okay, this dude's Tootsie outfit, not nearly as good as Scanlon's.
Who's my only friend? Who's my only friend? You are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Every minute. Are there any
people, if we've told you once, we've told you 100 times, do not put your dogs in the dryer without a bounce sheet.
Junior's a concern. But from the youngest
to the oldest. Why don't you squeeze my nose till it bleeds? How would you like it if I squeezed your back fat, huh?
This is an Arctic type dog in toy
size. Hey, that's our dog.
With all the Arctic coat.
What kind of batteries do you think this thing takes?
Tiny ears. Here's the Maltese.
Gandalf. Grab the ring, Frodo.
This breed, they must be icy, icy white, beautifully groomed. That coat must be just like silk patterns.
Get some Crest white strips, Malty.
No marks of any other color in the coat at all.
Okay, how high is this woman's hair on the left? Well, higher than Redman on tour in Amsterdam? She's a trailer trash terrier.
Is the Offenpincher?
Last Passover, I got $5 for finding the Offenpincher.
Grandpa hid it behind the painting.
Closely related dog, the Brussels Griffon.
There's a rat on the floor! Rat on the floor!
Chihuahua.
Donde está Señora Renahan? Yo quiero back fat.
Divided by color. Solid color and broken color.
There's the back of Tina Turner's head.
Is a Pekingese.
I'm your private prancer.
If you can believe it. There comes the little girl with the pug. I told you to keep an eye on her.
Can we get this over with? Dreyfus invited me to an after party.
There you have it.
Whoa, hey, don't hit that pug.
One, two, three, four,
she's the Bobby Knight of dog trainers.
Vicky Abbott.
Congratulations.
Winning the toy group, the Brussels Griffon.
I hate
second,
you.
The Pomeranian third,
I hate you.
And the pug.
I hate you.
My dog hates you.
What differentiated them all?
Well, as long as no one's looking, I'll just take a bite out of this.
Dude, that woman totally ate a milk bone.
Come on, Ran. Who hasn't taken a bite of a Gainsburger just to see if it tastes like real meat?
Club of Chicago, the Terriers are next.
Well, the Boston Terrier is going to come out for a piece of this.
Dude, you're not going to believe it. I'm at the dog show. I'm like Noma.
Put legs on the ground.
Well, that's typical Boston.
What? It raises your expectations, then loses in the end?
Typical Boston.
The poor Boston Terrier. I mean, he just has the worst luck. At the start of each show season, he always looks like a serious contender, but then something always gets in the way. It's like he's cursed.
Oh, yeah. Well, Rand, there are actually loyal Boston Terrier fans who believe that there is some sort of curse. Take a look.
My name's Faba. I'm a Boston Terrier fan. Pretty much been a Boston Terrier fan my entire life. You know, my father was a Boston Terrier fan, and his father was a Boston Terrier fan, his father's father, and then his father's father, not so much. Every year, you know, we do really well. We get great trainers, we get the best pups, We get new coaches, and then I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's in the water or, you know, if it's something that Dukakis did. But we can never win Westminster.
The last time a Boston Terrier won Westminster was in 1918. What happened 2 years later gave birth to what is now known only as the curse.
Some guys sold that terrier off. What happened was they crossbreeded it with a Yorkshire. I don't think I have to tell you. Yorkshire, York, New Yorkie, and we haven't won since.
Since 1920, the Boston Terrier has had to watch the Yorkie capture title after title, while he can only reflect upon a few close chances. He almost had it in 1975, before the Irish setter dubbed the Big Red Machine stepped on his tail. But it was 1986 that stands as the defining moment.
It's close to the final round, and they go to the tennis ball competition, and ball goes right up to a Boston Terrier. He's got it, and it goes right between all fours. We couldn't believe it. He never missed a ball. I mean, he was a little rickety, you know? He had bad knees, this fella, but he was solid. And that was it. We lost.
Mired in despair, along with legions of Boston Terrier fans, Art Farber has set out to single-handedly reverse the curse.
What I did was I went out, quit my job. I was selling fake IDs in Harvard Square to college kids, a lot of Asian kids that had come into town because they're wicked smart. Went down to the shelter and found Buster. We went home and I started grooming him ever since. And I still sell fake IDs a little bit on the side, you know what I mean? You know, just to get by. Go get it, Buster! Get it! Get it, Buster! Get it! The other thing about Buster that's pretty cool is he talks to me. He'll talk to me. He's not going to talk today because he doesn't talk in front of other people. But when we're alone, he's very funny. We're not ready for Best in Show right now, you know? But in a couple years, we're going to do it. And we're going to be Best in Show. Best in frickin' show, fella. You could take that to the bank with you. You could tell all of Boston, our father said so.
Well, I don't know about you, but I got a lot out of that piece.
I did too, and check this out. I got this wicked fake ID from Art. Say hello to Alex Takinawa.
Dude, Ran, you do not need a fake ID. You're 31 years old.
Okay, first of all, it's Alex, all right? And second of all, we'll see who's laughing in 3 years when I'm a member of the AARP, fool.
All right, stay with us for the exciting conclusion of the 1990 International Kennel Club of Chicago Dog Show.
All right, I'm talking mad money off all cafeteria-style eating facilities.
It says you're a Korean war...
What?
Korean War veteran?
Yes.
Care that Ann Rogers Clark handled three poodles to the Westminster Best in Show victories in 1956, 1959, and 1961. Do you care that she has been picked as Judge of the Year on three different occasions and Dog Writer of the Year once? Do you care that one of the dogs Clark bred, Surrey Spice Girl, won Best in Show at Westminster in 2002?
Wait. Didn't that dog crossbreed with David Beckham's poodle?
No, Franz Beckenbauer's German Shepherd.
Ah! All right, we're going to take you back out for Best in Show, which is basically a showcase showdown battle royale of all the best from each of the classes.
And the only thing fixed are the dogs themselves.
Skip to it!
Siberian Husky is a sled dog.
Look at how gold her coat is. You got to eat a lot of eggs to get your dress that shiny.
Heavy freighting loads. Trailing tail is...
Check out the snow dog.
Yeah, even he hates Cuba Gooding Jr. now.
There's Best in Show from last year, the Afghan.
The bald guy in the suit?
Very regal dogs.
Aloof.
I heard that dog was a rescue. They found him in a cave in Tora Bora.
Yeah, and when they asked him to shave off that little chin hair, he refused for religious reasons.
Pantaloons all are indicative of the Afghan.
Take him straight down and back, please.
You take him down and back, Pimlet. You do it.
I'm running in a suit. I'm running in a suit.
Who are you, Tom Green?
No, dude. I'm still on the air.
Sort of emulates his dog.
Well, they always say that people resemble their dogs.
Yeah, but they really only say that about ugly people.
Mary Burke showing her golden retriever.
All right, let's see what's going on in the trunk.
Talking to her after the judgment.
Dude, you're eating my hand.
You're literally chewing off my fingers.
He's a breeder, owner, handler of this dog.
Jerry Krause looks riveted. That dog doesn't have any legs. Just hovers above the ground like that little magician from He-Man. It looks kind of like the scrubbing bubbles guys. Totally.
Know that they're into the final part of this and their hearts are thumping wildly.
Is it mildly or wildly? Ooh, sparkly.
Mind as she goes over to enter her book.
I'll have the spicy tuna roll and the salmon sashimi.
Let's look over her shoulder. She's marking the golden retriever.
Did they just announce the winner? Whatever minimal suspense there was now is completely gone.
Trophies. Okay.
And now they're showing us the winner before it's announced? Have these people not heard of suspense? Look, everyone's gone. Yeah, well, they already told us who won. Now she's just toying with him. She already knows who won. She's on some Jeff Probst power trip.
The moment is now.
No, the moment was 30 seconds ago. Sparkly.
And there it is, the Golden Retriever, best in show.
Oh, my God. The Golden Retriever won. I did not see that coming.
Mary, obviously you're tickled, but I want to
find... Is Ann Rogers Clark like 6'10"? She's more like Keon Clark.
I was very impressed with it.
Sparkly.
It was a lovely quality lineup. And I...
And the winning dog gets to drink from that cup for a year. No, no, it's like the Stanley Cup. It goes around to every kennel that that dog's ever been to for the year.
The word go, he couldn't be denied. His condition... Sparkly. His movement.
Well, I love this dog more than my own children. And who wouldn't? I mean, just look at him.
Well, you couldn't tickle me anymore because...
But if you'd like to try, I'm staying in room 360 at the airport Marriott.
Breed, and then he won the group under me tonight. And to have your own, have your dog go best in show is very thrilling.
You have run. Run like the wind, woman.
Good luck for you.
Okay, can we go back to that shot of the depressed guy in the crowd?
Yeah.
What did this guy do to his wife that made her drag him here? Did he, A, wear a Bulls jersey to her sister's wedding, which, for the record, it did say black tie optional, or B, mistakenly record 60 minutes over the series finale of Moonlighting, C, leave their son at the mall, or D, both A and C? Ah, the answer's D, both A and C.
Ah, I always get it wrong.
Me too.
All right, when we come right back, we'll switch gears and watch some Cheers. More cheap seats after this break.
I thought it would have been...
I always get it wrong. I thought it would have been deep. I never get it enough. Alright, welcome back to Cheap Seats. Ready? Let's go! Alright, we got one more segment of Cheap Seats left, so let's really hear it out there.
Yeah!
Let's go, Cheap Seats!
Nice ball, baby!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Cheap Seats!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Woo! Woo!
Here's the University of Egypt, Cairo
Tech. Here is defending champion Memphis State University.
Or Memphis State. They have an enormous Bedouin population.
I heard that.
Wow, this was back when Memphis still had its state. Back to the Penny Hardaway days.
Shout out to Keith Lee.
Lineage, right? Rand, what are you doing?
Filing that under moves that I'd never be able to do.
Ugh, this is kind of getting boring. It's just the same thing over and over.
Whoa, I'm interested.
Yes, get used to that movement, because most of you will be waiting tables next year. Wow, that last girl's really close to the curtain. She's fine. She's nowhere near it.
Ow, my head.
All right, this is boring. We gotta fast forward. Laura, what are you doing? We nixed that whole part. You gotta start coming to rehearsals. Guess who the choreographer's daughter is? Should they be mad while they're doing this? Hey, why did the audience suddenly start screaming? Did A.C. Slater just walk in?
Quentin time!
Well, thank God that's over. I gotta go to the bathroom. And now on to the totally superfluous mascot competition. Hey, that's not real fire. He's not really playing the piano. That's not a real tiger. That's not a world championship belt. And he's not actually reading the paper. Lies! Oh, mascot lies! Lies!
And Western Kentucky University's...
This guy really puts the mass back in mascot. All righty, let's get back to bringing it on. And the only squad from Kentucky that'll punish you if your nickname is Tubby. Where's our music, Greg? Where's our music? You're ruining everything! I've never been more happy.
Dude, I'm gonna fall asleep. Fast forward it.
Totally.
I'm getting really uncomfortable here, okay? Two more Ks and I'm out of here. What, dude? It probably means that, like, Randy Johnson just struck someone out swinging. Or that this routine is kosher. All right. Let's move ahead to the awards ceremony and see who takes home the gold-plated plastic.
Second place goes out.
Why do you write the winners on his hand? Yeah, there are only like three winners. Do you really need a crib sheet? She so wanted to say number one.
Yeah, she was like, we're number two. It's almost like number one, but it's two.
And for the national champion.
The 1990 College Cheerleading National Champion is North Carolina State University.
North Carolina State, huh? We didn't even see them. Did you really need to see what they did?
No.
This is really the proudest moment in NC State athletic history.
Yeah, I mean, I can't think of anything better.
Wittenberg, oh, it's a long ways. They won it!
Nope, this is really the proudest moment, yeah. Well, it's that time of the week again.
I noticed that you were acting a little moody.
I was moody, yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, it's time to give out some cheapies.
All right, cheapie for best costume. I'm going with the breakaway genie pants. I'm going to say Pat Scanlon for his brilliant Ann Rogers Clark disguise.
You broke that away, too?
Yeah, that was a breakaway disguise. Cheapie for biggest dog in the show. I'm going with this one.
Nice. But I'm going to go with this one.
All right, that's going to do it for this episode of Cheap Seats. We hope you've enjoyed yourself.
And let's remember, the only judge that really counts is the little one deep inside of you. I call mine Mini Judge Mills Lane.
I call mine Mini Judge Hatchet.
All right, see you next time on the CS. See these files again.
I got to refile these.
What? Where did they go? We've got goblins in the studio!